Travels with the Stevensons. Today's show is about my life that Ms. June's doing in life history. And I thought it would be a good idea to, on our little visit up to my sister Judy, in located in, I believe it's called
Glendale.
There's a restaurant up here we like to come and meet at each year around Christmas time or a little after or New Year's. Two of the oldest pubs in England are the Cock and the Bull. And in Stony Stratford of London, during the 1800s, all the news was carried by travelers on the stagecoaches.
I wonder if they had fake news then.
Probably had a lot of fake news. Both pubs claim to have the latest news and embellish stories to make them more interesting. Hence the term Cock and Bull Story. And we happen to be at the Cock and Bull restaurant here again this year with my little sister, Miss Judy Lynn Felty. Judy Lynn Stephenson Felty. A former school teacher. Of course, once you're a school teacher, you're always a school teacher. And we have some interesting stories about that. But she taught first grade in Kenton County in the early days. And she's been a wonderful, wonderful little sister her entire life. So I'm going to turn the camera operation over to the lady that has given me this gift as a Christmas present, the story of my life, Ms. June Geiman-Stephenson. And Ms. June is going to do a little interview about Judy and I, and I'll ask some questions too. And but Ms. June's going to be our videographer here at the Cock and Bull Story Restaurant. Okay, Ms. June? Well, we're here today, Ms. Judy, and at the Cock and Bull Restaurant, and again this year. And I'd like to take you back to your memories first. You have memories on Wolf Road? What are your memories of Wolf Road back at Taylor Mill, where we lived there, where Mom and Dad had the house built there?
We had a dog named Colin. All the Colin.
Well, we had the Culberson. Mr. and Mrs. Henrietta Culberson. And then yet, the babysat you, yes they did. Oh, is that right? Yeah. Then we had the Williams, the Hope Williams and his wife, next door. And they babysitted probably some too, I imagine. And but we had the Williamses. And of course, now you were a little younger than me. What year was you born in? 1947. She and I was born in 43. So you were about 4 years younger than me. And
she still is.
Still is 4 years younger than me. I'm 75 now, and you're 71. Okay. And there goes a train by. That reminds us a lot, doesn't it? That's the train track was right by the Cock and Bull here. And of course, our father worked on the L&M Railroad even while we were there on Wolf Road. And he used to walk to work. And Mom packed his lunch. He walked down to what was known as the Corsi Yards, where I later worked, and where Dad's father worked, and where Dad's dad was actually killed right there on the southbound hump. When Dad was just 5 years old. And of course, Grandpa Bingham at one time worked on the railroad too. So we have a great deal of railroad history in our backgrounds. Dad worked there all of his life, frankly, other than farming. And he was a great farmer and a great produce grower. There's real great talents there with the green thumb. But we remember him walking back and forth to work there at the course of yards when we lived in Wolf Road. And then we went to, as little kids, we went to the Felty Baptist Church with Brother Huss as a minister, Brother Shelton. You might remember them. And then back in those days, Pete Bingham was there. Some of the other Binghams went to church there at the Latonya Baptist Church. But when we moved out to the country...
Like, how long were you all at Latonya Baptist?
We were there just about, all of our early life until I was about seven. And then,
do you remember it at all, Judy?
Do you remember Latonya Baptist at all? That's probably who you remember, Aunt Maple being there. The Culbersons, yes, the services Henry Culbersons. And they were wonderful people there. Their little brick house still stands there, 2 doors down from where Mom and Dad had their house built. Which I found out an interesting story, June, after the fact from one of the teachers in her 90s, reminded me that Mom had went out and gathered all the signatures needed to gather a petition to stop a liquor store from being put up again up at the end of the street there at Wolf Road. I think I told you about that, didn't I? Well, she was the one that did that and led the drive against Nick's Grove coming there and putting in a liquor store right here at the end of Wolf Road because I think mainly probably because Dad had been an alcoholic, and she didn't want any opportunities or a place of bar because Dad was right there where they lived. And so she gathered those signatures up to them, take them to the Planning and Zoning Commission, and Mr. Dieter said she got it stopped. And they moved on out further out the highway now where Nick's Grove is still out there. And I've had many a meal out there with him at the place out there. And the family. Now, Mom and Dad, when they moved from Wolf Road, of course we had the Williamses down the street, we had the Halberstadts, we had the Luzaders, Donna Luzader, who's married to Phil Resnick now, where we had a Bible study class, June, with them there at their house just recently. And then they had the Waymans, where they got our milk grown there, the old farm. And the Kerrs lived there up the street. And then we had Patsy Bell and Gerald's friends, including Bob Marshall, Robert Marshall of Marshall Toyota down in Dry Ridge. And he's living down in Florida now, probably in his 90s. And his son Rob is the one that sold me with all the other workers there helped. Sold me the Toyota that we're driving right now. Isn't that interesting? It goes back a long way. But Judy, you went to Simon Kenton High School too. And who do you remember? Some of your teachers that were in the elementary grades? Do you remember many of those at all? Or a few of them? Williams. I'm trying to think of who you might have had there. And then did you go on up to Simon Kenton High School then? Simon Kenton Elementary up to Simon Kenton. Now you remember some of your teachers there? At Simon Kenton? So I can tell you one you remember. Mr. Reuben Hensley. Principal? Superintendent of school. You mind telling us that little story again? Can't remember it all. Can I tell a little bit of it? Well, Judy, of course, worked her way through college and after graduating from Simon Kenton High School. Of course, I have a little better memory of some of this because I'm a little older than her. But I never will forget, of course, she sang a lot of songs like I did. She sang a lot of songs. She sang at, I think, one of the big gatherings they had at the, for the prom, right? It was the shindig, it was called. And you were the queen.
Not in high school.
I think you were something in high school there, too, where you sang the song. You sang at the shindig. Okay, well, you sang there. And probably had Mr. Either Robert Roden or the music director of the chorus. Band leader, wasn't he, Robert Roden? Yeah, I'm trying to think what his name was, and I can't touch me right now. Bill something, that was William something. But he was a great man. It'll come to me in another show. But anyway, Judy went on to Cumberland College, and do you remember the president's name down there? Was it Boswell or? The president at Cumberland College, and you were the queen there at Cumberland College, I remember.
Once upon a moon.
She was queen, and because I escorted her one time for the Mount Laurel Festival, and which is all across eastern Kentucky, and she was representing Cumberland College at the Mount Laurel Festival as the queen. And you graduated from there, and then you had your teaching certification then, and you started teaching, I think, the first grade at Kenton Elementary, or in the Kenton County system. I think it was over at Beach Grove. This was the school. But then an interesting thing happened. Well, of course, folks, there's always interesting things in teachers' lives. Now, I'll say this for Judy. She was one beautiful young lady, and I happen to know for a fact that she was pursued by many young men from Cumberland College and other places, and because it was like a merry-go-round to figure out who she was dating and what was going on, and because she was so attractive. Well, this one fella, for sure. No, am I? Okay. That's the truth of the truth. And this one fellow caught her eye. His name was Don Felty. And she had accepted a contract to teach there at Beach Grove School, right down from where the church is there, June, at
536
Mount Zion Road, Bethesda Community Church, where Ms. June, by the way, as we've mentioned, is going to be teaching a ladies' Bible study on Esther, starting on February the 11th on Monday night from 6:30 to 8:15, which will be wonderful. But Judy, being in teaching the very beginning of the year, she had fallen in love with this gentleman, Mr. Don Felton. Of course, he's a rather suave and debonair, a handsome guy, and I can understand why. He just, she just was, I'd say she was a little crazy about him, frankly. And so, if you know anything about teaching school, there's something called the Red Book or the Blue Book or the Bird Book. But anyway, it's the book that every teacher has with all the records and everything of the students, attendance, and et cetera. So, Miss Judy, fall in love as she has, was coached to coming down in Georgia, hopped the plane, took off, madly in love, to get married. Well, guess what, folks? She took the bird book with her. And Reuben Hinsdale, as we called him back in my day, Reuben Culpepper Hinsdale, was a little shook up and excited at the fact that she had the bird book with her. And of course, she later explained to Mr. Hinsdale, "Mr. Hinsdale, haven't you ever been in love?" But when he came to me, a teacher, and went came to Barbara Jean, our oldest sister, who had taught for many years and was a teacher, we very well knew what the importance of the bird book. It was like the life of knowledge for a school teacher. So, unbeknownst to Mr. Hinsdale, though, there were several things that happened to cause the bird book to be lost. Now, one of those things was your car was stolen. Isn't that right?
And the bird book stolen with it. The bird book was not only lost because of love, but some thief stole the car, stripped it all down, took it, and everything was missing and gone. So they just had to rejuvenate a new bird book. And I'm sure that Judy will always be remembered by Reuben Hinsdale, even in heaven, because him and his wife were both school teachers. And I'd have to say I was quite proud of my little sister for answering the call of love. And it must have worked because you just had your 50-year anniversary of marriage to Don Felty, didn't you? And we still got a farm up in, you all have a farm up in, where's that located? Up in Eaton, Ohio, and it's called what? The title of the farm? Plenty Ponies. Plenty Ponies. And you can see that on his website. I think he's got a website. Plenty Ponies.
And there's a side note.
What's a side note?
I said, sorry,
I remember that. She sent a letter of apology to Mr. Hinsdale.
But I did love my husband.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. She took off. She was in love. And believe me, knowing Miss June, you probably know I've done some various things by impulse for Miss June. And it hasn't changed a bit. Love is a magic potent spell. So those are one of the little stories. Now, growing up with your little brother, or your big brother, Johnny, of course you had an older brother, Gerald, who was off in the service. So we didn't see much of him until he came back home from the service. And Mayor Ruth, she met a fellow by the name of Jackie Robinson. And of course she had another fellow pursuing her by the name of J.D. Sims. And believe me, had another one on top of that. In fact, my sisters, all of them, including Barbara Jean, they were pursued because all three of them were magnificently beautiful. They were blessed by God, just almost like this June is. It's a blessing. You know, you get that gift of beauty, as I've often said. And it's one of the reasons I try to get her on the television show with me as much as I can. But anyway, Judy, do you remember your brother Johnny there growing up on Martin Road particularly?
I remember something.
You were my protector. Was I
your
protector? Well, I tried to be. Well, I was.
Now we would.
Oh yeah, I'm sure we did.
But I don't know if somebody else started asking. No, no,
I was right there. Well, I'm glad to hear that. I'm glad to hear that. Now, you had some good friends. You remember Brenda Roy?
Brenda Roy and her sisters, Jackie.
You remember Carol Kerr? They lived up the street from us, Mr. Fight Master.
Jack Kerr,
we loved to listen to him play the banjo, didn't we?
Yeah.
There on Martin Road. Mrs. Noakes. Jimmy Noakes and Mrs. Beckett. Mrs. Sam, a beautiful, wonderful lady, who was the mother of J.D. Sam, who courted and fell in love with Mary Ruth.
I
And then there was, remember Mr. Covey, Carl Covey and his children, Vicki and Tim, little Tim, and I think there was another one too. I'm not sure. It was sweet. Mrs. Covey was sweet.
Right?
And Mr. Covey was one of the drivers of the bus that took us to hear Billy Graham speak. You heard me talk about that. Mrs. Lykins and Vernon Lykins. Absolutely. And Mrs. Smallwood, who went to see it in the hospital the other day. She was living right down the street from her. Her sons were dead in Haven, Smallwood. We remember playing with them, don't we?
Yeah.
Well, after the time of year, we got much younger. And then the Lions and Betty Lee and the Crosses, Janet Cross, Patsy Cross, and then Mr. Fightmaster, that was an older gentleman that played the banjo all the time. I think he had a hand in it, yes. But we grew up out there on Market and Moffat Roads, and Dad still worked on the railroad, but he farmed both on Wolf Road, but he really farmed on Market and Moffat Roads. And we raised gardens and took the vegetables to town and sold them, and you remember Aunt Bessie and all of the relatives we used to take vegetables to. And you remember going down to the little Kenton Baptist Church, don't you? Licenses and the Rhodes, Mr. and Mrs. Rhodes, and Mr. Grizel, John Grizel, and Brother Kerger, and Mrs. Polly, his wife. They were all wonderful people. Do you remember much about the church ride down the road to see Billy Graham?
I remember we got to go probably one of the biggest weeks of my life. I remember that. And others remember.
Yeah, absolutely. I never will forget the sermon that he preached and still used all across the country. It's the Holy Spirit's job to convict. God's job to judge, and it's our job, his job, and our job to love. And those were the three things that he left everybody, that message. And that's a message that the world needs to heed, particularly in all these traumatic and turmoil times. Now, Mayor Ruth lived with us there until she was pursued by Jackie Robinson. J.D., sort of got cut out of the box there. And he told me about that later down when I went to UK. He had me over to his apartment. And when I was down in UK and told me all about how much he was in love with Mary, tremendously in love with her. But she gave her heart to Jackie Robinson. He was a pretty smooth talker, I'd have to say. Plus, he was a minister over at the Little Church of Christ over on Taylor Mill. And that appealed to Mary Ruth a great deal, I think, because she married him and stayed married to him until he passed away here about, I think, around 3 years ago now. And they traveled all over the United States playing and singing, and some of you folks have seen their show on television that I put on there called the Kentucky Jamboree. Ms.June, have you seen any other questions I ought to ask here?
I just wanted to ask Judy what kind of brother John was.
Very loyal.
Loyal?
Very loyal.
Well, that's good to hear.
I could trust him and never had to ever doubt. Something that I knew I didn't have to worry about.
And I guess quite an athlete, wasn't I? Back in those days.
Yeah. He could hang.
Improvised. Do you think you could do that today, John?
I got a hold of a tree limb and break it off.
Well, we played together an awful lot out there. Eddie Smallwood, David Smallwood, Jimmy Noakes, Wayne Noakes, Jeff Noakes, all Bill Roy, all of us, Brenda Roy, all of us, Carol Kerr, all of us had fun out there, growing up, a fun time.
And you worked hard, too.
And we worked hard. And Mrs. Smallwood, I was with her the other day down at the hospital. She's had surgery. She's doing much better. I think she's going to make it to get home, go home. She's 93 years old, Eddie Smallwood's mom. She remembered our mom being her Sunday school teacher.
Wow.
And Mrs. Covey, we met over at the church in her 90s, and mom was her Sunday school teacher. Now, isn't that neat? And her son, Tim Covey, is now our music director at that Bethesda Community Church. So, and he is excellent, superb guitar player and singer. The whole group that we've got there, we've got some of the best musicians there at that church that you've ever heard. I mean, they are all fabulous. And they are a blessing from the Lord. So there, aren't they, June? To go to a small church like that and hear talent like that, filled with the Spirit of Jesus Christ, no doubt about it. And, well, Judy, now, I'm sitting here thinking, of course, how many children did you have? You had two children, Donnie and Melissa. Melissa lives out in Washington State and is an up-the-up person out there with all those computers and things, didn't she? She's a marketing, and she's a marketing genius. There's no doubt about that. I watch her on Facebook. And Donnie, he's still working, doing sociological work, helping people out. One son, Ethan, right? And just loving the pieces. He's cute as a button. Heart of the attack, he absolutely is. And Don not only is a financial consultant, but he works on the farm, trains the horses, has some beautiful horses up there. How many horses does he have up there now?
Well, we found homes for all of them except two
and a half. Two you have now, and then you've got cattle. What's the cattle you all have?
We just sold the cattle about 15 or 20.
15 or 20, and what kind of cattle were they?
Highland.
Yes.
And there's
kind
with the horns.
With the horns and long hair.
And
they're beautiful.
They look like right now.
That's right.
And we're lucky because, for the most part, they look really friendly. We still have a few up there.
Teacher for 4 years, and Mr. Gray lived right down the street from us on Martin Mullen Road. He had been agriculture teacher for many years at Simon Kent. So we got a lot of training from him, Frank Jackson, wonderful man, all the farmers in the area there. Now, is there anything else that you remember from your teachers at Simon Kent? Do you remember any of them particularly? There goes another train by, Ms.June. Can you get that train? I tell you what, one of the nice things to hear about, you got a live background, a live train going by. I can remember riding in many of those cars. Each one of those weighs about 28 tons empty. So if you get a load on it, it goes up to maybe about 65 tons. And I used to climb on and off of them, putting brakes on them, riding them over the southbound and up in the tracks. Dad did too, when I was a switchman. And it was quite a challenge. It was a dangerous job. I always tell people, I never worked any job in my life that was as dangerous as working on the railroad. It's no wonder that our grandfather Oh, yeah. Expression between